Hello and welcome to this course. In this lecture, we are going to learn about dashboard design principles. A dashboard is a visual interface. It displays data graphically and provides at-a-glance views into key measures. How you can have a simpler and more effective dashboard design? Here are the 10 basic rules. First of all, simplify your dashboard. Don't include too much data or too much information in a report. Keep it simple. Also, the less fancy formatting your dashboard has, the easier it is to read. Charts should present your data as simple as possible. Second, avoid using background fills or fancy effects like shadows, gradients, or glow. Also, pictures or clip art doesn't help. Three, remove elements that don't contribute to the core message. Here are some examples. First, you can remove borders. Second, you can avoid data labels that are not necessary. Third, you can remove grid lines, vertical and horizontal. And fourth, you can remove axes that don't use. Fourth, try to fit your dashboard and your data on one page. Maybe you can adjust column and row width or reduce white space. Fifth, put your most important measures to the upper left side of Excel worksheet. Users pay attention to specific regions. Sixth, use descriptive titles for each component. Seventh, use effective format numbers. Eighth, include a timestamp on your dashboard, monthly or yearly, for example. 9. When it's necessary, use a few comments or labels to help users clarify your model. And the 10th rule is to make sure that the users have to click a few times to get their data and the navigation is easy. Also, before starting to create your dashboard, ask yourself 3 questions. A. Where are my source data and how they will be organized? B. What calculations do I need to perform? And C. How and when I will update my dashboard? The most useful Excel functions for dashboards are VLOOKUP function, HLOOKUP function, CHOOSE function, and some product function. Of course, there are more. Don't forget to avoid the following issues. Importing too much data. You should only import data that's necessary for the purpose of the dashboard. And trying to keep your data model limited to one worksheet. If a user needs to scroll to view all the elements, it will be difficult to understand the data model. Thank you very much.